Have you heard about the great Big Bang that created the planets and led to everything? How the Earth was a ball of fire that cooled to a planet with oxygen, water that pooled into oceans of life, which was born in the sea and evolved over time into you, into me, into us, into them, into everyone here who persists in dividing ourselves by our fears of each other because of the way that we look through the lens that was given by culture, by books that insist that we each have it right, so they're wrong if they differ from us, or they don't go along with the story we tell to ourselves every day, or the way we expect other people to behave when the science has shown that we all go back to the same place, the same start, the same route, the same track.
My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. Oh, yeah.
Don't get me wrong, I'm not about to say that science will cause your convictions to sway. When it comes to religion, to what you hold dear, there's a way to hang on while you give up the fear that might cause you to judge those who differ from you and accept evolution as valid and true, because the truth as we know it is a miraculous confluence of events that could truly be divinely influenced. The wonder of cells breeding cells slightly changed that somehow survive due to genes rearranged. It's a mystery how these mutations begin, how offspring can differ from parents, from kin. But if these little differences help them produce more offspring than others, then we can deduce that the next generation will look just like them, and the group as a whole will be different. And then when enough generations and changes have passed, they'll give rise to a species so unlike the last that it's stunningly clear they can no longer mate with the ancestral species, and so speciate into a new species, a new form of life that's based on a previous model. All right, it's not about God, it's just about science, and the best way forward is through mutual reliance.
My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. Oh, yeah.
From fish to amphibians, reptiles to birds, to mammals, to primates, to people, observe the evolutionary trail is in our genes, so deep and distinct it can clearly be seen through macroevolution, the theory that informs us how life on Earth descends from previous forms. So trust that everything's related, we can't be separated, the animals have made it and thereby generated one new form after another through the happenstance of chance DNA that mutates and creates a variation that succeeds in its space to produce a generation that goes on to replace, due to adaptation, ancestral forms that just didn't work out when the environment changed by meteor or by drought. But there's one true thing of which we all can be sure: our DNA has been built on what came before.
My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. Oh, yeah.
I'll never tell you that we came from a chimpanzee. They didn't even live before there were human beings. But there is more to say, because our DNA is over 98% the same, and they aren't very different when it comes to anatomy. You ever see a barefoot person climb up a tree? We share an old ancestor, a primate form of yester. 5 million years ago or more began our long sequester. Dig in the ground and you'll find that you go back in time, because stuff piles up on top of other stuff and leaves behind a timeline of traces of people and places, fragments of faces and pieces of bone that have long turned to stone, reveal a real prehistory of our own. A species descended from a primate past, with hands made for building and a brain of such mass that it weighs about a third of our bodies at birth. And truly, it earns every ounce of its worth. The archaeology shows time after time that human beings evolved from a very ancient line, and every early fossil that has ever been found of people has been pulled out of the African ground. So human evolution must have had its start there from previous species and not out of thin air.
My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race.
Oh, yeah. All the other primates are covered in fur, but people wear primates. Mutations occurred that led to our status as the only naked ape as we adapted to our ancient landscape. Hot in the sun of the African equator, our early ancestors were in an incubator for cancer and heat rash, all kinds of infection that led to a melanin darkened complexion. This melanin's job while making dark skins to keep UV rays from really sinking in. The greatest danger of which to be wary is they break down, folate, and cause women to miscarry. So it stands to reason that the very first folks must have had dark skin to protect them like cloaks from the rays of the sun that could have done them in and caused the extinction of our ancestral kin.
My ancestors are your ancestors, since we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. Oh, yeah.
Skin had to be dark. It's a scientific fact. Our ancestors, African, all of us black. It's only when leaving that place of our birth that light skin evolved in a part of the earth where the days were far shorter, the sun less intense, the climate far colder, and in our defense, we were covered in furs. So the UV rays, they weren't enough to help us stimulate our cells to produce adequate vitamin D to get us through our early infancy and childhood with strong, straight, and healthy bones in northern climate zones. And if you don't get enough vitamin D, the problem with your potential pregnancy is that rickets may affect your interior girth and kill you in childbirth. So picture this, an entire generation of dark-skinned women with no accommodation for childbirth until there no longer appears the dark skin trait in the northern hemisphere. The women who happen to have lighter skin were lucky enough to produce the vitamins that led them to be the ancestors of those who moved into Europe and Asia through snow into the Americas, Arctic to Tropic, first natives, then conquerors, so misanthropic, who looked on the people as aliens and others when they all had the same great-great-great-great-grandmothers.
My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race. My ancestors are your ancestors, cause we all come from the same place. My grandparents are your grandparents, cause there's only one human race.